The man has dementia. There's no doubt about it. I've talked to doctors. I've had them look at 100 different tapes of his 5 years ago and today.
The Biden people say he's fine.
Oh, he can't recite the Pledge of Allegiance and he's fine. He was in the Senate for 160 years. I mean, he can't do the prologue to the Constitution of the United States or the Declaration of Independence, any of them. He actually displays symptoms that two gerontologists told me are classic symptoms of middle-level dementia. Right. That's when he does that, I pledge allegiance to the United States. I think done that twice. Well, that's a classic symptom in the DSM-5, it's the fifth symptom of dementia. He's got 8 of the 10. I think the president is quite right to say maybe he's taken Adderall or some kind of attention deficit disorder.
Right. And that's why the president wants to do a drug test. But, you know, none of us are doctors.
Yeah, I'd also check his right pocket.
This is just, that's your opinion. But so it will be interesting to see what happens tonight.
It's not just my opinion. It's the opinion of a number of doctors I've actually, interviewed.
Right.
Let's talk about the Supreme Court, because that's going to be a topic tonight at the debate.
Oh, man. They literally gave him multiple outs and he just kept doubling down and they were so uncomfortable. And when he makes it about Biden not remembering what the Pledge of Allegiance or other things like that, Trump has been caught on camera not knowing the words to God Bless America and the national anthem. So we really want to go down this stupid road? Who cares? This is so petty and dumb. And it's one thing to say, okay, Biden does not seem like he did in 2012 or even in 2016. I have said this on this show, right? I think that's going to be a huge issue for the Democrats. I really do. It's a whole nother thing to say, nope, he has dementia for certain. I talk to doctors. They say it. Well, maybe the doctor should come on TV and make those claims, except they wouldn't do that because it's medical malpractice. They are not able to diagnose someone without interacting with them and being able to do their own tests. It's just ridiculous. It was too far for even Fox there. But to me, what this showed is the debate tonight, this is a preview. Trump is 100% going to say that Biden has dementia in explicit terms, or maybe just implicitly, but he's definitely going to use this line of attack because Giuliani, he's Trump's buddy. This particular line of attack is one that Giuliani, whose work as President Trump's lawyer and top dirt digger on Hunter and Joe Biden, kicked off a chain of events that got his client impeached last year, has enthusiastically embraced as one of his primary functions now for Team Trump. Shortly before midnight on Monday night, Giuliani started texting the Daily Beast to say that Trump did great in recent White House debate prep, for which the president said on Sunday that Giuliani and former New Jersey Governor Chris Christie took part, and to rail against Biden as senile, broken-down old crook who's supposedly suffering from dementia and needs ADD drugs, projection, to get through the Tuesday debate. The Trump attorney also claimed that someone had told him how stupid Biden was in law school. Giuliani also mentioned late Monday evening that he'd be flying with Trump on Air Force One on Tuesday and would be at the Cleveland debate. Asked about what kinds of questions he peppered the president with during the prep, the former New York City mayor replied, "It doesn't really work like that with him. It's much more of a discussion rather than a rehearsal. Plus, you are dealing with a very smart, very alert human being, not a senile old man." These are the kinds of people that are advising Trump here. This is his debate prep team. Biden has two things he needs to do. One, he needs to lay out a coherent vision for America. And I know that's tough for him as a centrist Democrat, but he has to contrast it with Trump's chaos. And secondly, he cannot make this into a WWE-style smack-talking fest. That's the one thing Biden has to prevent from happening, because Trump will win if you get down in the mud. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. He has guys like Chris Christie, who's a trash talker for sure, if you recall how he single-handedly destroyed Marco Rubio in the Republican primary. Look it up. It's honestly fun to watch. And Rudy Giuliani, who is a crazy person, as you just saw, and who is so in the muck and in the right-wing bubble that all they can see is this trash talk and interpersonal conflict and things like that. There isn't policy. There isn't making people's lives better. That's not what this is about. So if that's what the debate becomes, Biden will lose the debate. But if Biden can just make it about simple issues of if your life is better, unemployment, the pandemic, even talk about how Trump's a grifter and how he stole your money out of your pocket by paying only $750 in taxes for 2 years in 2016, 2017, right? Like, bring up those things. Bring up policy. Don't make it a trash-talking contest, and don't let him make you angry, because Biden has a quick fuse, and that would play right into Trump's hands. Rudy Giuliani just gave you their playbook. Pay attention and don't give in.